this was my dad's round hay bale hauler. I took the forks off the back and made a higher area for a cable and shiv to go across to lift the cars up. I've got chains on this piece tied to the cable and goes over down to the winch. I found out the hard way you want to have both these chains exactly the same length, same type of chain. Makes a whole lot easier. They go up under the bumper and hook into the frame. This don't work so good with the newer vehicles and plastic bumpers. Works a lot better with the older vehicles, the old metal bumper. I have messed up a few bumpers with this deal. You said for a newer vehicle, this part here needs to be made somehow a little different. I just got it where this is angled up. And as you pick the vehicle up, it gets a little above center of the axle. You don't want it too far back, or it lifts the tongue up pretty hard. So I tried to have it where you have vehicle picked up, and the weight of the vehicle is just barely in front of the wheels. It don't always work like that. Another problem wrong with it is you turn very sharp, these wheels get back into the vehicle. These wheels on each side, if you try to turn. So with this deal, you can't turn real sharp. Still make do with it. It's got to be prepared for my corners. I've seen them made, and the wheels were skinnier. They didn't reach so far out to the side. You could turn sharper, but it wasn't near as stable. This is really stable. I never had a wobble out of it trying to lean or tilt, dragging vehicles around the rough terrain in the pasture and stuff. I just added scrap metal to make a higher point for the cable to go across, down, pick up on it. I just used scrap iron, as you can see. I didn't even cut them to length. I just, whatever I had, however it fit, I angled, double overlapped the angle iron on here. Really, it needs more bracing and stuff. And you just crank it up with this winch. Up and down, raise and lower your vehicle. Then I run safety chains from the top up here down to this, and from this back to the vehicle, from the vehicle back to this, just so nothing goes too far if it comes apart. Basically, it was just a bale hauler that I converted into a car hauler. I can unbolt this. I left it where I could unbolt it, remove all this and put my bale forks back on it and be a bale hauler again. There's a few things I'd have done a little different if I'd thought. I guess you learn. Also, when I tie on a pretty low vehicle where this sticks out here, it gets in the way. It needs to come on down straight and end, instead of having a piece sticking out. Being that's an old piece of grater blade, I don't see myself cutting that off very easily without a cutting torch. A fairly simple contraption, not much to it. Like I say, I'd add more braces if I was to do it again. I don't trust my welds. I'm not no certified welder. I just bought a welder and taught myself. And thank you for your interest.